No, I just made it up. I just put some of these snaps on there to...
That's the second time he's done that.
He did that on the hill.
I don't know if I want to tell you.
Yeah, there's a lot of companies.
That's stuff. Like four of those.
I almost like they're seen out of there.
Using YouTube and things like that to people are more interested in what you have. Until I actually get a store or somewhere to set up. There's an old Brady's is an old house in here.
That's power of the Brunswick.
I think they'd let you have more than these. I think that's one of those things, too, though. If you show them you can move their stuff, I think you could steal a dealership.
Couple.
We really only have to have room for one.
You would just
keep the floating
over. That could be interesting. That might be a nice price and take the other one out. We dive into the alley. But
that's what we're looking for.
What you do if you was a dealer is you just
You played over there.
I can do it.
I just said somebody should have to do
it. Well, I went up to the bar apartment and showed him how to do the rails the other day. He's got that.
Mine's giving me money, so.
What I'm gonna do,
it's actually, they were made from, things I can find out about it. They were made somewhere down around the Utah area. My uncle was a
Well built.
They, my uncle was on the road on the show, and like, oh, you know, the case, but he bought that ticket. He never used it. The first time I seen it, the case bill was pushed over the corner with a bunch of stuff. They moved, he got transferred to St. Louis. Then they came home for Christmas. His son's wife's dad had a farm out on the reservation. They came home for Christmas and he was complaining about having a storage shed down in Salt Lake for all his stuff. He wanted Barry to come to Salt Lake and get it. Well, my dad had a big wood trailer at that time. So I told him I would help pay for the gas and go with Barry down to Salt Lake and clean out the storage shed if I could get the pool table in his basement, because they were never going to see it. They said they never used it anyway. Then he moved back, eventually moved back to Pocatello, and never really wanted it, and they really bad on their cars. He wrecks a car in 3 or 4 months, and they're always bringing their cars to me and want them fixed and this and that. And I keep telling him, I said, well, you know, appreciate it. I'll tell you what, I'll keep on your car so I can keep them handy. You guys got a bite of paint and stuff, and all, but they wreck a car. They got a Nissan Murano last summer, and it's already been wrecked twice. And his wife, I don't care, she came up to my mom and dad's house one day and had one of those white Cadillac Verdes. Remember that white Cadillac Verdes? They had one just like that. She come up to me, she said, I kind of rubbed the steel posts on the front of their driveway. She said, I kind of rubbed the steel posts going into the driveway and scratched my car, went up there. She caved the steel beams inside the doors. And like, you did more than kind of rubbed it. Really. So that's how I got the pool table. What I want to do, the one place that buy a lot of shoes and stuff, they have what they call art stands. And it's, you can get designs put on the top. It's not raised like those Jack Daniels ones they have, it's raised. Yeah. So this is actually colored in the cloth. Doesn't affect the way it plays or anything. I'm going to have my logo put on the cloth, and so it's almost the whole size of the table. Make videos to put on YouTube about different things, practice drills and cottage drills, and promote my website and stuff that way. But it'll be able to see the logo for the whole time.
Yeah, well, if you get a cloth like that, then you have to be kind of careful about the structure, because you don't want it to be in the center.
Yeah. It's very expensive.